center, their 6'4 quarterback. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Caught right side, Davis. They show off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring it down. 10 yards on the pickup there, it'll be second down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Back to throw here. That's brought in by Davis over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they didn't get him down.
Watching that run takes me back to something a famous old coach once said. Any player he wants on his team, he wants him to be agile, mobile, and most definitely hostile.
Rutkowski, the fullback, on the inside give. Oh, now he bowls him over, and they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
I know a lot of times we like to put players in certain boxes. He does this and he does that. This guy, he can do a little bit of everything. He's not just a lead blocker or a guy who protects the passer. Handing the ball, he might want to get out of the way.
Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back now at the scoreless first half. It's a 0-0 game at half, so both sides obviously love their defense and hate their offense. Moving forward, we'll just have to see if it's the first to score that wins. All right, let's get it going. Here's the first half highlights. Panthers still on the field. Stewart's going to use a stiff arm to get away. He takes off and ends up picking up 12 yards on the play. We go down to early in the second. Davis able to get free along the sideline. And he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to their own 43-yard line. Continuing on the drive, tight coverage here, but the completion is made. And he ends up at the 29-yard line before he stopped on the play.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the 6. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. There are 0 points on the scoreboard for either side. It'll be interesting to see what adjustments were made. The defenses have obviously been great.
So if you like defense, this is a classic game. This is what you're looking for. But now you're trying to figure out how to gain any type of an advantage on offense. Is it through a big chunk play that they haven't seen before? Or is it just running your regular offense and letting it better, trying to create an opportunity?
Let's see what happens when they choose to go down. Now he's flushed out left. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the 3rd one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
On 2nd down, it's Tomlinson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. It'll buy some time right. Oh, he's
Teams battled through a scoreless first half. Finally, a breakthrough here in quarter number three.
And I just wonder how that played for both of them psychologically, because when you battle through a scoreless first half, now you know that every possession is increasingly crucial. Who can put points on the board, make the other team chase? What if you get a lift and if they get deflated a little bit?
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. He's got it, and the Vikings take a 7-0 lead. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Now we take a glance at the offense. It's their first possession of the second half. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline, because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Newton turns it hands to Stewart. And Stewart lost the football. It's loose. And the Vikings pick up the football. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line.
They may have the edge on the scoreboard, but that hasn't made them pass it, has it? I mean, they dialed up a pretty good run blitz there. And Brandon, you know that all blitzes aren't just designed to get to the quarterback in the passer. Sometimes you're just trying to take away every gap, every hole that might be created in a running game. And they did it to perfection. It caused.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. With Damian Tomlinson, 25 yards. And the Vikings capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit. But for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And he puts it through. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Now a play fake here on first down. And some room to work. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter of play. Second and very short here, less than a yard. From the gun, here's Newton. Can't fight it, he lost the football, it's out. And this belongs to the Vikings.
Well, that drive was in the case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needed to, having to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, two scores, pretty much game set back.
How about the takeaway, though? How about those defensive guys?
They'll look to throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. And they'll be disciplined.
disappointed to have to burn one
here. It means that many people were right, and you were wrong, which is usually the case.
So defensive timeout chance to regather, regroup.
Can't handle the difference of that beat, right? They're making its own way with it.
Set up to throw. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. Vernon Davis. A beast
in
the red zone with his
Jersey Shore
touchdown
situation.
Game. And a fumble recovery leads to 6 points for the Vikings. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get to the end zone as well.
And it is now 21 to nothing. Zerline out now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know, you just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once, we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares?"
Cam fighting, he lost the football, it's out.